the past, kids in wheelchairs or kids with disabilities or kids who looked a little bit different were very much locked away.
Nowadays they have integration, and our children go to normal primary schools for maybe one day a week. And even though they're not in the classes with other children, they just have a class that's on that site. The other children get to see them, they get to talk to them in the playground, and they're accepted.
The kids with disabilities, they're all so different. You know, I know you can't group kids together anyway, but all these kids, because some of the diagnoses they have are so obscure, and they're all so different from each other that you can't just put them all into one basket and say, here you are, you know, that this is what they're going to do, because they're all like really individual in their needs and requirements. It was very easy to decide where Ella was going to go to school, because there was only one school option for her. She goes to Fisher Road School, special school, and they have a program within the school that they go out one day a week to one of the local regular primary schools. And it's integration. So it's fantastic for all the other kids to see the disabled kids and accept them as part of society, as normal human beings like the rest of us. But on the other hand, it was very hard for Ella, because she finds it very hard to cope with noisy places, a lot of activity going on, and that sort of hum of conversation. She finds all that quite hard to deal with. So in the end, we said to the school that we didn't think it was working for Ella, and there was no benefit for Ella attending these classes. With Ella, it's a level of agitation that she will have had a bad day at school, she will come home, she'll be cranky, or it'll be written in her communication book from school saying that Ella was very miserable today, she cried, or whatever. And you just know that it's not working for her, because normally she goes to school and they can't, you get a little note in the book saying Ella's very happy today, enjoyed the foot spa, enjoyed listening to music.
From early intervention, you sort of learnt then how good or bad your child was, just through knowing some that were better intellectually went into a playgroup, whereas my daughter never did. So from early on I knew that, you know, the options for school would be limited.
You know, she attends the same school that Ben and Sean go to. We realised when she was a tiny baby is that she would go to the same school as her brothers, because, you know, how could we say to her that she couldn't go to the same school as her brothers? We wanted her to grow up to be an equal and confident. You know, she participates in everything the other kids do, you know, whether as a spectator or whether she's, you know, actively involved.
You know where they are, you know they've been well looked after, you know they've been kept busy during the day. They have a swimming pool, they get to do fun things, they have massages during the day. There's transport provided. Frequently there's therapies provided in the school, so you don't have to take them to therapy as well at school. School years are the best years.
Yeah.